In the family, I was the stubborn one. But do you know who was more stubborn? My dad. But beside that, we never had anything in common. And maybe that's why we never got on so well. And not so well here, I mean. We even barely talked to each other. In Vietnam, I was the kind of kid who loves hanging out, meeting friends. I crave for freedom. I want to live in my own world. In the contrary, my father was a man of tradition. I mean, it seems like he hated almost everything that I wanted to do. He banned me from going out at night. He was so strict to me with everything I did, with every word I said, and with every decision I made. We had such a cold war that anytime he got home, all we said was just a hello. I know. Many would say that's because he's worried. I tried to understand him too. He's a policeman. He had to work on tons of murderer cases. And we can say if there's anyone who's the most aware of danger out there, it's definitely my dad. I tried my best to prove that it's okay for me to follow my own decisions. I went to study in the city, which he didn't want. I became a good student. I got to be the president of my school's music club. I worked so hard, but for him, it seems like I was never enough. He complained about how I got dressed, about my friends, that the environment I was in wasn't good for me. It seems like nothing could help us anyway. But things changed. I grew up a bit. I realized, actually, he was always by my side. He's the one who always picked me up from school. He's the one who gave me everything I wanted. My keyboards, my guitars. He never said no to my dream jobs. He was just careful with the steps I took. And that was completely okay. But that day came. I had to move to Poland to study. At the airport, I hugged everyone so tight. But me and him, we could only say goodbye to each other. In the new country, I started to go to work. I started to see how stressful it was. And I thought, maybe this stress is nothing compared to my dad's work. I should have sympathized with him. Day by day, COVID stopped me from going back to Vietnam in summer. So I decided to stay here longer and wait. But then, my family called. My dad had cancer. The last stage. I never knew about it. My whole family never knew about it. Then he couldn't make it. The last day of his life, I was always there. When he was conscious, for the first time and the last time of my life, I told him, "I love you, Dad. Please get well soon." He was happy. He was smiling. And that was the last time that we ever talked to each other. That phone call was very long, very long. Turns out, the last time we met at the airport was also our last goodbye. I'm not telling you this story so that you can feel sorry for me. No. I'm telling you this story as a reminder. Maybe we never noticed how much our family loves us. Maybe we've gone too far to realize they're not there forever. And every last goodbye can be the last goodbye. Luckily, that day I could tell my father that I loved him. If someday I woke up and he was still around, I would tell it to him every single day. Dad, I love you. You tried your best.
If you tell me you're leaving, I'll make it easy. It'll be okay. It'll be okay. And if we can't stop the bleeding, we don't have to fix it. We don't have to stay. I will love you either.